in the league's 50th anniversary, your Wheat Kings are the champions.
Welcome to our first episode of We Are Brandon. I'm Ryan Shields, and our first guest is the Mayor Rick Chrest. Thank you for joining me.
My pleasure.
So in these type of chats, all we're going to do is like a fireside chat, a couple questions, just a very casual conversation, just to get to know people
first
a little bit
is
better.
Just how long have you lived in Brandon for, Rick?
Well, pretty much all my life. So full disclosure, I'm currently 58 years old, and was born and raised here, and raised in the east end of Brandon. I did spend a couple of years away from Brandon, going to university and working for a year, but by and large have spent my whole life here. I've had opportunities to be elsewhere, but certainly have loved Brandon and have had a great life here.
Awesome. Now, what's your favorite part about Brandon?
Well, there's a lot of things. You know, I would, you know, probably say the people. I like to think that we sort of have the best of both worlds here in Brandon, that I feel we're sort of big enough that we have almost everything here that a bigger city would have, and yet, you know, still small enough that we're you know, a very friendly community. You kind of walk down the street and know lots of people are quite friendly and progressive, and you know, kind of a great attitude. So it's, to me, kind of the full package. We've got the, you know, all the trappings of a big city, and yet the atmosphere of a smaller town.
Well, absolutely. I know, like, when Jen and I moved back, everybody was like, oh, you're moving to a smaller community coming from Calgary. And like you said, it has all the amenities, especially now with the airport, that a big city does. But we'll run into friends every time we go to the rink or everywhere. It's a great community that way. When you wake up every day, what kind of drives you to be your best self?
Well, you know, I don't know, that's a tougher question. Certainly, I guess I've always, you know, wanted to do the right thing and, you know, do the best that I can. You know, it's probably a characteristic that, you know, gets ingrained in us at an early age. You know, my parents were, you know, really good, hardworking people, and so I had a great upbringing that way, and, you know, was just always taught to, you know, do my best and, you know, to be, you know, good to others and so on and so forth. So, you know, I guess I continue to carry that on, and, you know, when people speak to me in my role as the mayor, if they say that I'm doing a good job, I just respond, I'm doing the best I can, and I think people appreciate that, and I've always kind of given back, volunteered a lot throughout my whole life. Again, a characteristic instilled at an early age, and I just believe that it's great to do that, feel good about doing that, so I'm just trying to make things a little better no matter what I'm involved in.
Yeah. Speaking of being the mayor and that, what would you say is your greatest career achievement?
So I've had quite a varied and unusual career path, and I would never have imagined that I would have been in any of these things. My probably earliest career, not everybody knows this, I was once a general manager of the Brandon Chamber of Commerce. I started that when I was 21 years of age. From there I was at Simplot, it was now called Coke Fertilizer. I was there for just a year and a half. Then I was GM of the Keystone Center for about 9 years, and then into my own business at Leon's Furniture, and then finally sort of back into politics. I'd been a city councilor previously for 11 years, so coming into the mayor's role. So I feel I've had, you know, achievements in every one of those jobs. You know, certainly it was a great achievement to practically double the size of the Keystone Center when I was there. Certainly, you know, it was a great personal achievement to be involved in my own business at the furniture store, and certainly you know, I felt very gratified to have had the public put their trust in me to elect me as their mayor, and certainly enjoying that and doing the best I can.
Is there one specific thing that's kind of been a highlight for you since becoming the mayor that you can think of?
Again, it's hard to limit it to one. You know, one of the things that you know, was a priority was to kind of keep finances in line, this council has done a great job of keeping tax increases to a very modest level. In the three budgets we've turned in, we've Our total tax increase has been one third of the rate of inflation. So I think that's been a great achievement. So that's kind of boring though, but it's very necessary and has a profound impact on every taxpayer, every resident, every business, you know, wants their taxes kept in line. So we're have a good record that way. But then we're able to do some more. We want to move the city forward and keep the city maintained. We've got some great developments going on at the Riverbank Discovery Center. We'll be building a new spray park beside Valley View Community Center this year. Landing the Briar was certainly a highlight that was a personal goal, if you will, of mine. I think that we got accused of going at this a little bit in unorthodox fashion when one of the functions at the Canada Cup, I just announced that we're coming after the Briar and all the Canada people. Did he just say that and whatnot? So
that'll always be a highlight of mine for sure, being a part of that. Yeah, so
right on.
When people are starting out new ventures and that, you always get nervous or whatever. So when you were finally deciding to run for mayor and that, what was kind of like the most nervous part of that for you?
Probably the most scariest part. I felt, because I'd been on council for 11 years previously, I wasn't that concerned that I would know how to do the job. I felt that I'd be able to get that figured out, and there's a lot of great people here that are going to help you through that. But what was more concerning to me is what impact it would have on my family. You're definitely in the, in the fishbowl, and that's fine for me. I've chosen to kind of do that, but then by association, my whole family gets sort of dragged into that. And sometimes it's controversial. There's a lot of drama that goes on, or you got to make unpopular decisions. And I was concerned that would my family have to experience some of that negative side of politics. And I'm happy to say that the people of Brandon have been extremely kind and have been very good and reasonable, and we haven't had a lot of sort of bad controversy. So my fear of that was happily a little unfounded, and it's been, I think, pretty good for everyone in my family. I don't know that people are yelling at them that much. They do wait to do that, and frankly they haven't yelled at me that much either, so it's
worked out pretty good that way. So I know I mean we see around town all the time at different events and different functions and that going on. So when you can get some time just to get away and kind of unplug in that, what do you like to do just kind of recharge and relax in that?
Well, you heard me mention my family, so it's certainly the most important thing to me. My wife and I have three kids, and so spending as much time with my family, almost no matter what it is fine with me. In the summertime we have a little cabin up at Ditch Lake, so definitely cherish the time with them up at the cabin and out on our pontoon boat and just kind of kicking back. The winter time is kind of busier with respect to council, and I've got a lot of functions and meetings. So again, taking a night off on a cold night such as tonight, minus 22 while we taped this, by the way, it's great to just then hunker down inside the house. Maybe we watch a little TV and have dinner together, and so that's really what kind of charges my batteries.
Absolutely. Now, this is one of my favorite questions, and I mean, Jen and I have three young kids, you have young kids and that, so I'm always trying to be able to teach our kids something and hear what other people say. So with all of your experiences in that, what if there's one message you could tell the youth of today, what would that message be?
Well, I guess it would be, hopefully I can explain it, to kind of be flexible. You heard me say earlier that I've had a varied career, and I never previously imagined that I would have been in any one of the things that I've been in. I certainly didn't imagine I'd end up being the mayor of this fine city. So, you got to, keep improving yourself, but stay flexible, be prepared to take a kind of a windy road in your life. Things don't happen overnight. I often say, even with goals, I use the phrase, how do you eat an elephant? One bite at a time. Again, that rings true for younger people, that you're not going to get to your final goal just overnight. You're going to have to keep kind of biting away at that. So kind of stay flexible and just kind of get out there. You know, our own kids in university now, I've said, don't worry about having the end goal in mind. Just get in there, just get started, and you're going to discover new opportunities and new occupations and new interests that you never even knew were out there until you just get out there in the system. So just keep your eyes open and keep your head up and not be afraid to make course changes along the way.
Perfect. Well, that's it for episode one. I'd really like to thank Rick for your time and that. Thank you very much. And then we'll be back next month with another guest.